All right, you have come to the last lesson of our GTM for Beginners series here. And congratulations, if you understood everything and followed along, then you should already be well on your way on using Google Tag Manager efficiently. Nonetheless, Google Tag Manager is a really big topic. And if you really want to dive into it and become proficient at it, then you need to practice much more and also know what you just don't know yet. So in this video, I want to show you a little mind map that I created in order for you to become a really good Google Tag Manager implementer. So let's take a look here. Google Tag Manager is a pretty big topic, and I created here 4 or 5 strings that will show you what you actually need to learn. The first thing is obviously the fundamentals. So the fundamentals here are really about why use Google Tag Manager, why should you use it? We covered a little bit of that in our beginner's lessons here. And if Google Tag Manager is actually a tracking tool, or is it something else that's actually in between that? So you need to be clear on these questions. Now, on the technical side, you also need to know about the implementation and how and what the different types of implementation there are, how it impacts site speed, and what are the capabilities of tracking with Google Tag Manager. On the other side here, we also have privacy implications of Google Tag Manager, security concerns that might be out there, and if you want to deploy Google Tag Manager not on a website, what are the capabilities on mobile apps? So once you're clear on these, a lot of people already start and implement a lot of things with Google Tag Manager like we have done it in the course. I actually find it much more important that you learn about the 5 pillars, the components of Google Tag Manager. What are those? Well, really there's the snippet that you install on your website. Then you have the data layer, the tags, the triggers, and the variables that lead into a tracking deployment. And you need to know all about these. We have talked about some components here, but just to dive into it a bit deeper. So the data layer is a very important concept that you really need to understand in order to use all the capabilities of Google Tag Manager. And for the data layer itself, you will need to learn the syntax, writing an actual data layer in itself. So that comes down into what is a JavaScript array, what is the difference with JSON, the key pair values, the data types, and so on. And then also you need to understand the event key itself inside of the data layer. Writing, you need to know how to write a data layer push in order to send this on to your developer itself. We have data layer versus data model, and we also have here the tools that you would need to be familiar with for the data layer itself. Now we also have tags, triggers, and variables. I will skip over them since we have talked about them in this course. But then there are also something called templates. So what are the use cases of the templates itself? We have utilized a community template already for our Facebook tag. So you might be familiar with that as well. But inside of Google Tag Manager, you can manage your tags as the name already implies. And there are many different functionalities, like you can do version control, workspaces, exporting, importing, containers, environments, approval queue, and user permissions. So there's a lot more than what we have done in this course alone. Then you can dive into the tracking deployments. We have looked at several tracking deployments already: Universal Analytics, GA4, Facebook Pixel, Google Ads, Bing Ads, Pinterest, LinkedIn, Twitter, and TikTok. These are just some of the tags that you can obviously install. And some of them are similar, but a lot are a little bit different. And you really need to have done one of these implementations in order for you to call yourself as experienced in these tracking deployments. Then we have some tracking techniques as well. So for example, iframe tracking, form tracking, all these different interactions that you can track, cross-domain tracking, if you are using, for example, Universal Analytics, UTM parameters. We can do a lot with Google Tag Manager to manipulate how we are sending data over to our tools. And there are different techniques. A lot of them we also describe on our videos, so you can check those out as well. But I'm just showing you here what you can really do with Google Tag Manager. Custom task is a really cool thing if you utilize Universal Analytics at the moment and want to manipulate your tracking inside of Google Tag Manager. And then there's this whole concept around cookies. So how would you be setting cookies, reading cookies as well, something that you would need to understand itself. So as you can see, there's lots more to learn in Google Tag Manager, and we have a lot more information on our YouTube channel, blog, as well as little mini courses that we do from time to time, or live trainings on our website. So if you want to learn more about Google Tag Manager, definitely check out measureschool.com. But if you're really committed and want to take the next step with your Google Tag Manager journey, then maybe check out our Google Tag Manager Beyond the Basics course. This is a course that I've created where I really want you to practice your GTM skills. So you will get access to our demo store where you will be able to install your tracking. And then we have these little challenges for you where I give you a little challenge to try out to implement something and a solution video. So you'll be able to control what you have done and get some more tips on how to actually do this efficiently in your Google Tag Manager account. So I think it's a perfect next step for you after this beginner course to go and learn more about Google Tag Manager, get used to the tool and work with it more efficiently. So if you want to check that out, head over to measureschool.com/GTMBTB for Google Tag Manager Beyond the Basics, and there you'll find more information. Well, it was my pleasure to introduce you here to Google Tag Manager and this little beginner course. We have tons more material, obviously, on our website and our blog. And I hope I could create that little bit of curiosity to utilize Google Tag Manager. I think really it's a great tool and everybody should be using it. So thank you so much for watching. If you have any kind of comments, then please leave them down below. And if you want to share this video, then hit that thumbs up button. We would really appreciate it so we can share it to more people out there. Now, as always, my name is Julian. See you in the next video.